stretching, opening the back, opening the ribs, gathering in the palms of your hands, and bringing it into your body, and relaxing the pose. Letting your lungs and tummy, your abdomen, especially fill and inflate. Gently open hands. Never quite locking the elbows. You can add an optional turn if you wish. Moving with your breathing. So you're letting your breath drive your motion or face your motion. You're setting yourself to your breath. Gently gathering in your hands like it's a literal ball that, you know, like a cotton stuffing you're gathering from the air. Opening your ribs, opening your shoulders, opening your back, and then relaxing. Breath goes all the way down to your tummy. Nice deep slow breathing. We never quite lock those elbows, but the shoulders, even though you're stretching, let the shoulders relax. Reverse direction now. Go to the inverse. We'll open and close, drawing up from the middle, inhaling as you draw up, exhaling down to the side. Open, breathe, inhale, relax, close, exhale. All the same things as I was talking about before, like you're gathering a ball of cotton in your. And as you breathe in, pulling this ball up through your body. You can add an optional turn if you wish. Gently open hands, never quite locking the elbows, never quite locking the knees. Moving to the pace of your breathing. Now, a lion plate ball, holding a large imaginary ball in your hands. Gently carry it to the one side, turning your hip, not your arms. Roll the ball over, and gently carry it back to the other. Roll the ball over, relax the shoulders, relax the elbows, gentle with the hands. One thing I really like to do with this one, you can glance at yourself in the mirror if you're in a place to do so. Look at your own shoulders. How tense are your shoulders? How tense are your hands? And release some of that tension. Allow your body to gently ground. Think about how much your feet are working. Can your feet relax? Can you feel yourself grounding and sinking through your feet? So breathing, breathe deep and nice and slow. leg. Keep the knee flexed a little bit. Do not straighten that knee over. And then reach to your back leg. Keep that knee flexed a little bit. Do not straighten it over. Nice and gentle now, back and forth. Unplank the back leg. Breathing as you go. Inhaling. And exhaling. Again, relax the shoulders. Relax the tailbone.
Relax your tailbone. Remember the other thing about relaxing your arms. go all the way down to the end, and just turn around and go back.
Softly set that foot down, softly put the foot up. Be on balance for that entire step. If you were to have to stop at any point, if someone shot you with a freeze ray and stopped you in the middle of the step, you would just hang out. You would not fall over. You would not pretend on that foot. Right? If you have to go in reverse all of a sudden, pull that foot back up and go in reverse. Do that. Be on balance the entire step. If you've done this class before and you'd like to do a different move other than foot, if you want to do, say, ward off or brush knee or something else, absolutely feel free to work in a brush knee or ward off or some other move. About reaching out gently with the heels of your palms. Again, if you've had this class a little bit before, also think about that little bit of rotation. Where is that in this?
Change how our footwork is. As I always like to talk about, like this being a full step through, we're going to change this, and instead of being a full step through, we're going to do what I call a half step. The big difference is, with a full step, whatever foot is in front changes. Now it's my left foot, now it's going to be my right foot, etc. With a half step, what foot I start out with stays the front foot. I don't take a full step, I take a half step. Half a step, half a step. Okay. A couple of things about half stepping that brings out that I really like. I talked about moving from the center, moving from the core. Okay. This really helps think about one particular way of moving from the core, which is the rotation. When you take your step, don't think about picking up your foot. Think about instead turning your hip. As you turn your hip, it pulls your foot up. Now I'm going to think about turning my hip the other way. That pushes my foot out. Then I'm going to think about turning this hip. Pulls it up. And turn this hip. Pushes it out. So I'll do that every single time. I'm turning the hip. Very briefly, this habit turned too. Did you see that? I'm exaggerating that just a little bit. But did you see the hip? Cool. You're turning all the time. But I like the half step because it really brings it to mind while you're doing it. Okay? So let's practice this. Choose a foot to start out with. I'm going to start on my right. You guys can start on whichever guy you guys want to. Okay? And with your hand, you can keep it really simple and just reach out like you're going to, again, touch the heel of your palm to something. Okay? And half step. Step only as far up as your own ankle. Okay? And step up. Turn the hip. Turn the hip. Relax the shoulders, relax the arms. Make this still be smooth, right? Heel of the palm. Relaxing the arms. When you reach the end, turn around, maybe switch which leg is in front. So little slow, but be smooth. Nicely done, everybody. Shake your legs out, roll your hips around, do what you need to.
here, do a little stretch if you need to, where you can feel okay to go to the other side. Okay? Other side. Same thing. Leg up in the air. Big side-to-side circles. Or if you need to, put that foot down and just roll the hip from side to side. Do so. Just do so lightly. Use your reference. Just do it so lightly again. Make sure you go both directions.
Little device here. Put that out of the way. Gently open them up. Be alert, be alive. nice deep breath. Relax down. Separate feet. Roll up one side. Roll it down. Roll up the other side. Roll it down. It should be just a comfortable standing distance. Raise and lower hands. Inhale, inflating. Coming up to not quite shoulder height. Come back. Push it all down and out. Ward off. Turn out of the way. Catch. Go to the corner. Extend out. If you're holding it in the crook of your arm, touch down the foot. Turn forward. Land into that front foot. Grasp sparrow's tail. Catch again. Turn to the windows. Slide the foot forward. Bring this up in the crook of your arm. Reinforce it with the back hand and move forward a bit. Roll back and press. Come around and take this like it's a huge ball. Sit back to your back leg, make a big circle. Come forward and press all the air up between the heels of your palms. And taiju push, open up. Sit back. And gently nudge forward. Remember, this is not your arms, this is your body. Single leg, sitting back and turning. Go down and get the low, like, ray out of the dirty bucket. It was dripping on my hand. As Jackie pulled that all away from me, take my dirty hand. There's a towel on the towel rack. Lifted hands, turn forward. Lifted hands, I'm going to pretend I have a great big lower heart, a platelet heart. Take the front and back of it. Raise my foot. Bring it into my lap as I sit down. Now I'm all done. Shoulder press. Get my shoulder under, get the head of the heart. Push it back up. Turn. Hands. Grasp, excuse me. Train to the joint. Turn and scoop up. Toward the corner. I may fall on my shoulder. I'll touch down my foot. Try to fall off when we're off. Turn to the side and drill this thing off my shoulder. Scoops up with the other arm. Turn to the side and drill it off my shoulder again. Now, getting ready. Foot goes out. Cover my knee. Call brushing knee and twist. And I reach out and I touch somebody's chin. Play a harmony. Keep the front and back of the heart. Raise it. Lift it in the arm. Turn, throw it off my shoulder. Cover the knee. Tickle someone's brushing the knee into us. Again, same thing, but with a step. Cover the knee. Get ready. Get ready. Get fit. Step. Cover the knee. Brushing. One more time. Reach out with the heart. Oh, flip the loop. Flip the loop up. Into my mouth. Pause it off. Cover the knee. Make a fist. Turn to the back. Sit down. Big circle around. Do it again. Step through. Head is all up. My body is on. My arm is up. On my arm. Step through. Left down. Punch. Weird. Close doors and off. My body is in. Close. Breathe. In any of section one, I can do it. Together. Slow, but I'm going to try to do just a little less instruction. I tend to run out of breath during the talk at all. Because you're supposed to be breathing too, right? So, gently open hands, paying attention. Separate. Grasp sparrow's tail. Roll back and press. Push. Be real relaxed during the push. We say push, it's easy to overextend to lock your elbows. Single breath. Strain, stress, wind.